people have a false sense of food security because we go to the grocery store and there's basically always food there.
This is Mike Strait, and he's on a mission to reimagine the way we farm.
Large-scale agriculture has pesticides, uses a huge amount of fossil fuels, and is really rough on the planet.
There are lots of companies working on high-tech alternatives to traditional farming, but not quite like this. Instead of shipping produce from a farm in another part of the world, this founder wants to put the farm in a shipping container that can fit in your parking lot.
We're trying to feed the world one pot at a time by hyper-localizing farming and taking a farm and putting it right in front of the place that needs to use it.
FarmPod is a company that aims to increase food availability by combining vertical farming and automation with the help from an interesting source, fish.
We've kind of lost our connection to where our food comes from. We're taking it that whole extra step and we're saying, the relationship with the farmer is you. I don't know that we have an option for not succeeding. We have to make this work or we're not all gonna get fed. All right, let's go. You gonna show them the pod?
Mike Strait is the CEO and creator of FarmPod, and he developed a way to grow food indoors in a pretty tight space.
All right, this is upstairs in a FarmPod where all the plants live. By controlling the environment inside of something like this, we don't have to worry about it being too hot or too cold.
The FarmPod grows food aquaponically, which means their secret ingredient is actually fish poop.
You have fish in the bottom, the fish produce nutrients into the water. The water's flowing down through these towers, going through the plants. Inside of these towers is like a large filter material. Once the plants start absorbing it, this all then flows back down into the fish tanks downstairs. It's just constantly recirculating. We use 95% less water than traditional farming. A product like this has to be simple to operate. And if it's not simple to operate, it'll never get adopted.
The system allows users to grow produce without much work because it's automated.
You can run a farm pod on about 5 hours a week of labor. And then we have it all report to your smartphone, so it makes it easy.
Yeah, here's the graph of it.
It's a lot easier to control a system because we're imitating nature here. Hey, I just wanted to check if that last catfish guy came through or if we're doing the tilapia and we're good to go.
After starting an IT company in Santa Fe, New Mexico, Mike got the idea for FarmPod.
I've kind of been an entrepreneur all my life. I've always loved to garden. I happen to be a lazy farmer. I'd forget to water plants. I had this night where I woke up at 3 a.m. and I just drew a farm pod.
But to make this idea a reality, Mike knew he needed a partner.
Beecher being one of my oldest friends, I just called him up and I'm like, dude, got this idea. I want to build this farm that fits in a parking space.
I flew out to Santa Fe and we built the first prototype in 6 weeks.
The next day, I flipped the main switch, and it worked the first time. So that's kind of when we knew we really had something.
After the first prototype, FarmPod relocated to St. Croix to build up and test the system in a new climate.
All right, so this was sort of the ultimate plan, and this is where we landed based on the existing space in the pod.
We didn't want to put anything out that wouldn't be successful everywhere that it went. Deciding when we're ready to get it to market has been one of the challenges because we just want to keep solving it, and we're going to keep innovating. That's kind of what we love to do. Beecher and I work together really well because I'm the guy that gets out there and goes, let's make a million of these things, and he's the guy that always pulls me back because too much growth can be as much of a killer as not enough growth.
You'll put that in right here. Right there, got it.
We do have a very large order list happening right now. I'd say we are trying to tackle a lot at once.
Nothing like this has really been built. With each little box that's in here, it's probably the 10th iteration.
Hard days when it comes to development of the pod have never been an issue. That we love, we thrive on, it gives us energy. The biggest challenge is capital. We've run out of money 3 times, and we've had to fundraise within weeks or we would literally have to close our doors.
Shortly after FarmPod launched, Mike was presented the opportunity of a lifetime. A 7-figure exit.
A large national food purveyor offered to buy us. It was millions of dollars.
The problem was, this company wanted to buy them to shut them down, and Mike had to choose between money and his mission.
We realized that we just couldn't do that. If somebody wanted to buy us, they would have to be able to provide more food production to the world, or we weren't interested. we're doing something that is so outside of what anybody else has seen that getting traditional loans is tricky. But on the plus side of that, people that have the vision for what we're doing see the benefit and they want to be part of something innovative.
After 3 years in development, FarmPod finally has a version they're ready to bring to market. And St. Croix communities are first on the list.
We have to get back to the idea of producing our food more locally.
If we put the farm pod right there, right?
Yep.
And this is Chef Todd, a local restaurant and distillery owner, and farm pod's first customer.
And you're gonna be able to produce enough then for here and your other restaurants.
The other restaurants and the community.
We wanted to start local, both because we care about our local community and because it's an advantage to us to make sure that these pods are working right. The first people that we approached were restaurants.
Then, FarmPod found an unlikely customer.
What we found out was that schools were extremely interested in this. This thing is kind of a perfect classroom. So we can do STEM learning in here. We've got all this cool automation and solar technology and robotics and 3D printing. Once we get back in touch with our food and we're experiencing it, it encourages us to eat it naturally. We get kids excited. We get people that are in different industries excited. And all of those industries are now coming together around this box that's growing food in the middle of a parking lot.
Mike is one of a number of founders looking to address food shortages and climate change with innovation, thinking both outside and inside the box.
The reality is we're gonna have to get more creative in our food production if we're gonna feed the growing population on this planet. There is a better way to grow food, and we're trying to show people that it's now here.